Okay, so tell me a story. This is where you're going to tell the story of Nixon and his men coming to you and saying, Stanley, we tried our best, but Gus just died on the planet. We can't get those boys up there safely. You got to help us. You said no. And they kept pleading about that. Patriotism, Russia, the boys. We'll get there in a couple years, funding, you know, the shtick. And I decided, okay. And then you got the gift from God, you know, a carte blanche for making.
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you. Over. That would be an honor. All right, go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House. And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made. I just can't tell you how proud we all are of what you do. For every American, this has to be the proudest day of our lives. And for people all over the world, I am sure they too join with America in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's world. And as you talk to us from the Sea of Tranquility, it inspires us to redouble our efforts to bring peace and tranquility to Earth. For one priceless moment in the whole history of man, all the people on this earth are truly one. One in their pride in what you have done. And one in our prayers that you will return safely to Earth.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's a great honor and privilege for us to be here representing not only the United States, but of peace of all nations, and with interest and a curiosity, and with a vision for the future.
And thank you very much, and I look forward, all of us look forward to seeing you on the Hornet on Thursday.
Look forward to that very much, sir.
Secondly, when you looked up at the sky, could you actually see the stars and the solar corona in spite of the glare?
We were never able to see stars from the lunar surface or on the daylight side of the moon by eye without looking through the optics. I don't recall during the period of time that we were photographing the Sona Corolla what stars we could see.
I don't remember seeing any.
I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again.
But we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again.